Dear sisters and brothers in Christ, good morning. Today is day of Pentecost. Let us begin our worship in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. As we prepare ourselves for the special anointing of the Holy Spirit, shall we all in unison sing to the glory of God, O Holy Ghost, thy people bless. Let us invoke God's blessings. Praise and glory to you, Creator Spirit of God. You make our bread the communion of Christ's body to heal and reconcile and to make us the body of Christ. You make our wine the communion of Christ's saving blood to redeem the world. You are truth. You come like the wind of heaven, unseen, unbidden. Like the dawn, you illuminate the world around us. You grant us a new beginning every day. You warm and comfort us. You give us courage and fire and strength beyond our everyday resources. Be with us, Holy Spirit, in this worship, and empower us to be your witnesses. Amen. Let us participate in the Litany of Pentecost. Christ has gathered the Church in unity through the Spirit. With sure hope, let us pray, Lord, hear our prayer. Maker of all things, in the beginning you created heaven and earth. In the fullness of time, you restored all things in Christ. Renew our world in this day with your grace and mercy. Your response, Lord, hear our prayer. Life of the world, you breathed life into the flesh you created. Now, by your Spirit, breathe new life into the children of earth. Turn hatred into love, sorrow into joy, and war into peace. Your response, Lord, hear our prayer. Lover of concord, you desire the unity of all Christians. Set aflame the whole Church with the fire of your Holy Spirit. Unite us to stand in the world as a sign of your love. Your response, Lord, hear our prayer. God of compassion, through your Spirit, you supply every human need. Heal the sick and comfort the distressed. Befriend the friendless and help the helpless. Your response, Lord, hear our prayer. Source of peace, your Spirit restores our anxious spirits. In our labor, give us rest. In your temptation, strength. In our sadness, consolation. Your response, Lord, hear our prayer. Shall we in unison say the following prayer? Eternal God, as you sent upon the disciples the promised gift of the Holy Spirit, look upon your church and open our hearts to the power of the Holy Spirit. Kindle in us the fire of your love and strengthen our lives for your service in your kingdom. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Let us enter into the act of confession.
Confession. Sisters and brothers in Christ, we have come together to hear God's most holy word and to receive the body and the blood of the Lord. Let us therefore examine ourselves in silence, seeking God's grace that we may draw near to him with repentance and faith. You who truly and earnestly repent to you of your sins and are in love and peace with your neighbor and intend to live a new life following the commandments of God and walking from now on in his holy ways, make your humble confession to the compassionate God that you may be reconciled anew to him through our Lord Jesus Christ. Let us all say together the corporate prayer of confession. Almighty God, you poured your Spirit upon gathered disciples, creating bold tongues, open ears, and a new community of faith. We confess that we hold back the force of your Spirit amongst us. We do not listen for your word of grace, speak the good news of your love, and live as a people make one in Christ. Have mercy on us, O God. Transform our timid lives by the power of your Holy Spirit, and fill us with a flaming desire to be your faithful people, doing your will for the sake of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Hear the good news. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and with fire. In baptism, you were buried with Christ. In baptism also, you were raised to life with him, through faith in the power of God who raised Christ from the dead. Anyone who is in Christ is a new creation. The old life has gone. A new life has begun. In the name of Jesus Christ, we are forgiven. Amen. Today is the Pentecostal Sunday. The theme for our meditation is, Come Holy Spirit, renew us. Shall we all in unison say together the collect for this week? Gracious God, the giver of Holy Spirit and the source of our renewal, we thank you for revealing to our faith ancestors in the visible sign of the tongues of fire. audible sound of strong wind, and the vision of the advent of the life-giving Spirit on the day of Pentecost. We pray that you may continue to recreate us with the power of the Holy Spirit to engage with you in prayer of Pentecost, to respond to your call, to constantly proclaim your liberating word, and to fearlessly witness to Jesus Christ in love and compassion. Through Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, world without end. Amen. Now we shall have the ministry of the Word of God, the Old Testament, followed by the epistle reading.
The Old Testament reading is taken from Ezekiel chapter 37, verses 1 to 14. Ezekiel chapter 37, beginning to read at verse 1. The Valley of Dry Bones. The hand of the Lord was upon me, and they brought me out in the Spirit of the Lord and set me down in the middle of the valley. It was full of bones. And he led me around among them. And behold, there were very many on the surface of the valley. And behold, they were very dry. And he said to me, Son of man, can these bones live? And I answered, O Lord God, you know. Then he said to me, Prophesy over these bones and say to them, O dry bones, hear the word of the Lord. Thus says the Lord God to these bones, Behold, I will cause breath to enter you, and you shall live. And I will lay sinews upon you, and you will cause flesh to come upon you, and cover you with skin, and put breath in you, and you shall live. And you shall know that I am the Lord. So I prophesied as I was commanded, and as I prophesied, there was a sound, and behold, rattling. And the bones came together, bone to its bone. And I looked, and behold, there were sinews on them, and flesh had come upon them, and skin had covered them. But there was no breath in them. Then he said to me, Prophesy to the breath, prophesy, son of man, and say to the breath, Thus says the Lord God, Come from the four winds, O breath, and breathe on these slain, that they may live. So I prophesied as he commanded me, and the breath came into them, and they lived and stood on their feet, an exceedingly great army. Then he said to me, Son of man, these bones are the whole house of Israel. Behold, they say, our bones are dried up, and our hope is lost. We are indeed cut off. Therefore, prophesy and say to them, Thus says the Lord God, Behold, I will open your graves and raise you from your graves, O my people, and I will bring you into the land of Israel. And you shall know that I am the Lord when I open your graves and raise you from your graves, O my people. And I will put my spirit within you, and you shall live, and I will place you in your own land. Then you shall know that I am the Lord. I have spoken, and I will do it, declares the Lord. Here ends the Old Testament reading. Praise be to thee, O Lord.
The epistle reading is taken from the book of Acts, chapter 2, verses 1 to 13. Acts, chapter 2, beginning to read at verse 1. The coming of the Holy Spirit. When the day of Pentecost arrived, they were all together in one place, and suddenly there came from heaven a sound like a mighty rushing wind, and it filled the entire house where they were sitting. And divided tongues as of fire appeared to them and rested on each one of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. Now there were dwelling in Jerusalem Jews, devout men from every nation under heaven. And at this sound, the multitude came together, and they were bewildered, because each one was hearing them speak in his own language. And they were amazed and astonished, saying, "Are not all these who are speaking Galileans? And how is it that we hear each of us in his own native language? Parthians and Medes, and Elamites and residents of Mesopotamia, Judea and Cappadocia, Pontus and Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia, Egypt and the parts of Libya belonging to Cyrene, and visitors from Rome, both Jews and proselytes, Cretans and Arabians, we hear them telling in our own tongues the mighty works of God." And all were amazed and perplexed, saying to one another, "What does this mean?" But others, mocking, said, "They are filled with new wine." Here ends the epistle reading. Thanks be to God.
Our gradual is gracious Spirit, Holy Ghost. Now, let us hear the gospel lesson.
The gospel reading for this morning is taken from Gospel according to St. John, chapter 16, verses 1 to 11. Gospel according to St. John, chapter 16, beginning to read at verse 1. "I have said all these things to you to keep you from falling away. They will put you out of the synagogues. Indeed, the hour is coming when whoever kills you will think he is offering a service to God. And they will do these things because they have not known the Father nor me. But I have said these things to you, that when their hour comes, you may remember that I told them to you." The work of the Holy Spirit. "I did not say these things to you from the beginning because I was with you. But now I'm going to him who sent me. And none of you ask me, 'Where are you going?' But because I have said these things to you, sorrow has filled your heart. Nevertheless, I tell you the truth, it is to your advantage that I go away. For if I do not go away, the Helper will not come to you. But if I go, I will send him to you. And when he comes, he will convict the world concerning sin and righteousness and judgment. Concerning sin, because they do not believe in me. Concerning righteousness, because I go to the Father and you will see me no longer. Concerning judgment, because the ruler of the world is judged. This is the word of the Lord. Praise be to thee, O Christ.
My beloveds in Christ, as we celebrate the day of Pentecost, it's a joy and blessing that our senior presbyter, Reverend Dr. Moses Jayakumar, is here with us to minister to us. On behalf of each one of you and the pastorate committee, I extend a warm welcome to Reverend Moses Jayakumar and request him to bring the word of God to us.
Dear friends, I want to greet you all in the precious name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. It's a wonderful privilege to share the word of God with you this morning. And I thank the pastor for giving me this opportunity to be with you through this worship service. Today, you are joining in this online worship from your homes. If there was an opportunity to open the church doors for worship, and if you had gathered in the church, you would have seen the color red all around, the vestments, at the altar, and also the flowers and special decorations, including the stones. The significance of this color red for this Sunday is related to the festival of Pentecost. And red is the liturgical color for this Sunday. There is a recent trend. And the trend is that most of the church members, the members of the congregation also, would like to wear something in red so that they can match with the liturgical color. The color red symbolizes the appearances of the divided tongues as a fire that rested upon the disciples. Red is also a color for joy, the joy of the disciples when they received the gift of the Holy Spirit. The disciples, when they were filled with the Holy Spirit, were out in the midst of the large crowd, the crowd of people who thronged Jerusalem for the festival. And the people from different nations who gathered there heard in their own native languages what the disciples spoke. But today, we celebrate this event in a very peculiar situation. On that day, the disciples came out of their confinement. They came out of their lockdown situation. They came out of their self-imposed isolation. They came out to celebrate the gift of the Holy Spirit. But today, we observe this festival by imposing upon ourselves the rule of self-isolation and lockdown. We cannot come out to rejoice. Since our fundamental faith in Jesus Christ, we celebrate two important events in the life of Jesus as big events, and that is the birth and the resurrection, which we celebrate as Christmas and Easter. The other great event of the coming of the Holy Spirit does not get the recognition and the importance that it should get. Many Protestant denominations may not be observing this festival on this day, but the traditional churches or the liturgical churches consider this as a very important day to observe. We have to remember the difference between the festival of Pentecost and the Pentecostal churches. The festival of Pentecost started 2,000 years ago, whereas the Pentecostal movement as a church movement started around 1901. The word Pentecost should not be misunderstood to refer to the Pentecostal churches. It will be like identifying baptism with the Baptist church. The Pentecostal churches mainly focus on the gift of the Holy Spirit. But the true meaning of the word Pentecost is not the Holy Spirit. If you look at the verse carefully, the Spirit was given on the day of Pentecost, which indicates that there was already in existence a special day known as Pentecost. God commanded the Israelites to celebrate three major festivals: the Passover, the Festival of Weeks, called as Shavuot, and the Feast of Tabernacle, called as Sukkot. The Passover was celebrated on the 14th day of the first month. And the next day, the 15th day, was the beginning of the closely related another feast called as the Feast of the Unleavened Bread. And the next day, the 16th day, the first fruits of the barley harvest was brought before God as an offering. From that day, from that 16th day, the people had to count 7 complete weeks and one additional day to celebrate the Feast of Weeks, which is the 50th day. On this day, they also brought the first fruits of wheat harvest. Shavuot, that word for Festival of Weeks, is translated into Greek as Pentecostas, and in English, that is Pentecost. Though the Feast of Passover was the main event in the life of the Israelites, God commanded them not only to celebrate or observe Passover, but also observe these two festivals when they bring the first fruits of the harvest, barley and wheat. That is to enable the people to understand that God did not only give them freedom from slavery in Egypt, He also provided them the nourishment which they needed. And later, the Feast of Pentecost was associated with the law given by God to Moses on Mount Sinai. The church today, we count 50 days from Easter, from the date of resurrection, and celebrate this day as a festival of Pentecost. We know that Luke is the author of the Gospel and also the book of the Acts of the Apostles. His ending in the Gospel marks the beginning in the Acts of the Apostles, the second volume. He ends the Gospel with the words of the risen Christ to the disciples, where he promised them the gift of the Holy Spirit. Along with the promise, he also instructed them to wait for the power from on high. The second volume, the book of Acts, he mentions these words at the beginning. He starts by saying, "Theophilus, I wrote about," and all those things. And later he says, he ordered them not to leave, but to wait there for the promise of the Father. So both these words, the concluding words in the Gospel, the words at the beginning in the book of Acts, clearly indicate that the coming of the Holy Spirit is a fulfillment of the promise made by Jesus. The theme for this Sunday is "Come Holy Spirit, renew us." The Hebrew word for spirit is ruach, and this word also means wind or breath. Breath or breathing is the uppermost subject in our city, in our state, in our country, and throughout the world. The COVID pandemic affects our breathing, and those who are affected with this virus knock every hospital for oxygen. During these days, we are paying more attention to our breathing. Check your oxygen level. And that is the slogan for today. So at this time, we realize the importance of this great gift that God has given to us. That is the gift of life, the gift of breath. We realize that breath is not something that we can take for granted. We are constantly reminded about the importance of our dependency on God, who breathed life to create human beings. The scripture tells us that breath is not, our spirit is not only physical, but also spiritual. According to John in his gospel, Jesus imparted the Holy Spirit by breathing on the disciples. They were all breathing already, but Jesus gave them the spirit, the breath that will nourish them, the breath that will guide them, renew them, revive them, give them hope, and fill them with life eternal. So today's theme is a kind of prayer where we pray saying, "Come, Holy Spirit, renew us. Come, Holy Spirit, renew us." From the three readings, I want to focus mainly on the second reading from the book of Acts, chapter 2, verses 1 to 13. The brief background when we read the passages related to this event, particularly in Luke and also in the book of Acts, there are a number of words starting with the letter F. 50th day, festival, what the Father has promised, fulfillment, filled. This observation made me to think of other words starting with the letter F, which I can use for the meditation, and God helped me with three words: faith, freedom, and fellowship. Faith, freedom, and fellowship to speak on the theme. Renewal is something that is revived. If something is not performing its job properly for what it is meant to do, it is revived, it is renewed. It applies to everything. It applies even to our body, the conditions of all the parts in the body. When the disciples were filled with the Holy Spirit, there was some kind of a revival. And today we remember that revival when we pray, "Come, renew us." Let us see how the disciples experienced this revival or renewal in their lives, particularly in the areas of faith, freedom, and fellowship. So the first word with the letter F is faith. Though the disciples spent close to 3 years with Jesus in his ministry, they are seen as those who lacked faith. They could not understand the words of Jesus. They could not understand Jesus himself. The time Jesus called them to follow, to become his disciples, they exhibited this quality of lack of faith. The very beginning in the book of, in the Gospel according to St. Mark, he points out how Jesus admonished the disciples. They were traveling in the boat, and a great storm rocked the boat. At that time, the disciples cried to Jesus, "Teacher, do you not care that we are perishing?" Jesus calmed the storm and asked them, "Have you still no faith?" So throughout the ministry of Jesus, the disciples continued with the same attitude, lack of faith. Remember how the disciples responded to the great news of the resurrection of Jesus. When the women who witnessed to the empty tomb ran to tell the amazing news that Jesus is risen, the disciples did not show any sign of belief. Mark in his gospel says they did not believe it. Luke is very blunt. He says, they did not believe the women because their words seemed to them like nonsense. So the first believers were the first to disbelieve. They failed to believe in the words of Jesus, even when the risen Lord appeared to them. Later, when the two disciples who were on their way to Emmaus came back, rushed back to tell them their experience with the risen Lord, they did not believe them either. It is the lack of faith that made them to stay indoors. When the risen Lord appeared to them, they did not dare to ask him anything because they realized their weakness, their inability to trust in the words of Jesus. In this situation, the coming of the Holy Spirit transformed these folks to become strong in their faith. Filled with the Spirit as a group, they spoke about the mighty acts of God. That is what we read in verse 11, chapter 2. The mighty act of God starts from the incarnation. God sending his only Son into this world to be born as a poor human child. It includes the teaching, preaching, and healing ministry of Jesus. It continues with Jesus suffering on the cross, submitting to the will of the Father. The same God raised him from the dead. So the risen Christ was the foundation of their faith. Later, Peter, as the leader or as a spokesperson for the group, addressed the large crowd of people and declared with a strong faith. He said, "This man handed over to you, God has made him both Lord and Messiah. This Jesus whom you crucified." By the gift of the Holy Spirit, the fearful fishermen became faith-filled preachers. The Spirit enabled them to return to the basics of faith and to stand in their faith in the midst of all kinds of opposition. They were firm in their faith. Their faith was such that when the religious authorities commanded them to stop preaching, Peter and John replied, "We cannot help speaking about what we have seen and heard." The second word with the letter F is freedom. The faith-filled disciples move out of their self-imposed isolation to come out and praise God in the midst of the festival crowd. Faith produces freedom. From the time Jesus was arrested, the 11 disciples lost all their freedom. Freedom to move about freely. And they were confined to the upper room. The attitude of the disciples when Jesus was arrested is explained by Mark in these words. They ran away. They disappeared from the scene. When Jesus was crucified, none of the disciples were around except the women, who stayed till the body was removed, carried to the tomb, and placed in the tomb. Again, the events on the first day of the week exhibit their fear. The news that Jesus is risen did not wipe out their fear. Peter showed some kind of a response. He came running to the tomb to see what had happened. He saw, went back to continue with his self-imposed isolation along with other disciples. The sight of the empty tomb did not have any impact. The appearance of the risen Lord twice in the upper room did not give them the strength and confidence to come out of fear and move out of their confined life. They feared arrest by the authorities and the religious leaders. Sometime later, the 7 of the disciples came out of their isolation and were seen by the Sea of Galilee. But that was not an exhibition of full freedom. Still, they needed extra courage and strong conviction to move about as free people, followers of Jesus. The risen Lord instructed them to stay in Jerusalem for the gift of the Holy Spirit, what the Father has promised and what Jesus had prayed for. After this, they slowly began to come out of their fear. They chose a person to fill the vacancy caused by Judas and went to the temple every day. That is recorded in Luke 24:53. After this, in obedience to the instructions given by Jesus, they stayed in Jerusalem to receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. The experience of the freedom when they received the gift of the Holy Spirit. When the crowd saw the faith and freedom with which the disciples were praising God, they wondered how the simple Galileans, the rural folk, without much education, were speaking loudly and without fear. The astonishing fact for the crowd was the people who came to Jerusalem for the festival of Pentecost from 17 different geographical locations could understand what the disciples were preaching, what they were saying. The Spirit gave them the freedom to come out of their fear, from their loneliness, from their hopeless situation, to proclaim the greatness of God. They boldly preached with confidence to thousands of people, defying the religious leaders and risking their own lives. They faced all kinds of persecution and opposition because they were so zealous for the message to speak about the true God. Their freedom transformed the fearful followers into aggressive preachers. Freedom is the cry of every person today all over the world. We cry for freedom from the pandemic, freedom from fear of sickness and death, freedom from economic burdens, freedom from social insecurity. At the same time, we also see how this freedom is criminally misused through some inhuman acts by a greedy section of the people and the corrupt people who want to accumulate wealth for themselves. They are determined to profit from the sufferings of the people. People struggling to breathe are the source of income for such persons. Freedom is not to do whatever we feel like doing. And the purpose of using the freedom is not to help ourselves, but to help others. A quote from Martin Luther goes like this: "A Christian is a perfectly free lord of all, subject to none. A Christian is a perfectly dutiful servant of all, subject to all." The great model for this freedom is Jesus, who emptied himself to take the form of a slave. True Christian freedom comes from the faith in Jesus. There is a beautiful quote that will be of great help to understand the real meaning of freedom. It goes like this: "A justified person, a believer, is free and owes allegiance to no one but Christ. At the same time, being the most free, he or she is the most free person to serve." The third word with the letter F is fellowship. The expression of true faith in Jesus is not only in experiencing freedom and using it to love and serve others, following the life of Jesus. The faith is expressed in creating a new fellowship. We see this new fellowship among the disciples and the believers. The Holy Spirit created a new community of believers who were firm in their faith and who did not use their freedom for any selfish purposes. They used their freedom and faith to create a new community, to establish a new community of caring and sharing. We normally refer to the festival of Pentecost as a day of the beginning of the church. We say That is the birthday of the church, because on that day, nearly 3,000 Jewish people accepted Jesus as the Lord and Messiah. One important observation from the story is that the disciples, who were only thinking about themselves, their own position, their greatness, and they were thinking about this even when Jesus spoke to them about going to Jerusalem and the impending suffering, death on the cross. But those disciples were surprisingly together to receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. The scripture says, when they were all together in one place. The preparation to receive the gift of the Holy Spirit itself has created a strong fellowship among the disciples. When they demonstrated their faith and freedom, a fellowship was created among people of different geographical locations. As mentioned earlier, there were people from 17 different ethnic groups. The identity of the new community was not based upon shared culture or shared language, but instead was based upon the Spirit's gathering of people under the Lordship of Jesus. The Spirit did not destroy the languages or the cultures of the people, but enhanced the quality to forge a new fellowship, irrespective of such divisions. There was no place for superiority of a particular language or a culture. The Pentecost crowd would have had no difficulty in understanding the preaching, either in Greek or Aramaic, because those two languages were the trade languages. But the Spirit enabled the disciples to speak in the birth language of the people who were from different parts, the diaspora. Later, when the disciples and the believers gathered together as a new community, their entire lifestyle underwent a terrible change, a drastic change. The new community, there was no place for one person being rich and the others being poor. They began to feel that whatever blessing that they have received in terms of prosperity, in terms of the wellness in life, was not for them to enjoy or feel high of themselves, but to share with those who do not have such privileges in life. The scripture says, all who believed were together and had all things in common. Today, the theme invites us to pray, saying, come, Holy Spirit, renew us. Yes, let us remember the importance and the need of this prayer. Let us pray, saying, come, Holy Spirit, renew us and strengthen our faith to come closer to you. Renew us to experience the freedom in the right spirit following your ways. And renew us to create a new fellowship of people who will cross all kinds of social barriers and create a new living fellowship. Amen.
I thank Reverend Dr. Moses Jayakumar for bringing us that profound insights from the Word of God. It's always a blessing to be ministered by this servant of God. On behalf of each one of you, I want to express our gratitude to him. And now, in response to the message from the Word of God, shall we all in unison affirm our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed? I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died and was buried. He descended to hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended to heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Dear sisters and brothers, once again, a formal welcome to each one of you to our online worship service. as we are suffering from the second wave of the COVID-19 virus, our worship services through physical presence have been cancelled till government lifts the lockdown. For the benefit of the congregation members, the short order of Holy Communion service will be pre-recorded and shared every Sunday at 7 a.m. Our Cathedral YouTube link will be shared, and our worship service can be viewed anytime at your convenience. Please kindly attend our online worship service and be blessed. At your residence in a convenient place where the whole family can come together to participate in the online worship, it is suggested that on a table, a cross, open Bible, along with bread and wine, be kept as you participate in the Holy Communion service. As we sing the offertory hymn, let us offer our tithes and thank offering to God by online payment to church bank account, or we can set apart our offering and pay to the church office and obtain a receipt. Please note the church QR code and bank details will be projected on the screen. Due to lockdown, the church will be closed for prayers. Please note, no marriage, baptism, Holy Communion, or any other services will be conducted during the lockdown period. No funeral services will be conducted in the cathedral. All funeral services will be conducted in the chapel at gate number 1 in the Hosu Road Christian Cemetery as per the government restrictions and rules.
With deep sorrow, we regret to inform you the sad demise of Colonel Joseph George on 17th May 2021. He was 95 years. His mortal remains were laid to rest on the same day at the Hosu Road Christian Cemetery. Colonel George was one of our colorful elders of the cathedral. He was instrumental in starting men's fellowship in our cathedral, and he has served several bieniums on our building committee, and also he has served as Diocesan Property Committee convener. He was a brave army officer who has won several gallantry awards. His sad demise is a great loss to the church and society. Please kindly uphold in your prayers his bereaved wife, Mrs. Prabhat George, son, Sudeep George, and daughter, Suvina Benjamin, and the members of the family. Thank you. My beloveds in Christ, happy to inform you that our Mission and Evangelism Committee, along with COVID St. Mark's Essentia team, has organized virtual healing service next Sunday, that is 30th May 2021, evening at 6 p.m. The topic is the Compassionate Christ. The preacher for this healing service is Brother S. R. Manoha from Rays of Love Ministries. Poster, Zoom link, meeting ID and passcode will be shared. Please kindly make yourself free to attend this healing service and be blessed.
Dear Cathedral family, we are happy to introduce a helpline to support our congregation members by offering possible assistance during the public health emergency. Following are the services offered: online free consultation, beds with oxygen and ICU admission, psychological and counseling support, consultation and blood tests, emergency medicines, food and prayer support. The contact details are furnished. Please kindly make use of these services. Thank you.
Elections to the Pastorate Committee for the Triennium 2021 to 2024. Election is scheduled to be held on Sunday, 13th June 2021. If the lockdown situation continues, the Pastorate Committee will meet and plan to postpone the election to another convenient day suitable for all of us. All those who are 20 years of age and above, on or before 31st March 2021, and who are communicate members should register themselves as voters. As per the Constitution and Bylaws of Karnataka Central Diocese of the Church of South India, a voter or a candidate should have been a member of the congregation for an unbroken period of 12 months prior to the election and shall have obtained a valid transfer certificate from his or her previous CSI pastorate and give a declaration that he or she is not a member of any other church. The provisional list of voters has been displayed on the notice board and on our cathedral website since 23rd April 2021. Please kindly check and inform the office in writing through email if there is any additions, omissions or corrections to be made. Please note the list of the names of those who are celebrating their birthday and wedding anniversary during this week is furnished on our website. At this time, let us say a special prayer for those who celebrate their birthday or wedding anniversary.
Let us pray for those who are celebrating birthday or the wedding anniversary today or during this week. Gracious God, we invoke your blessings on all those who are celebrating their birthday or wedding anniversary today or during this week. Bestow your blessings on them according to your riches in heaven. May your presence, providence, and protection be with them in greater measure than it has been ever before. Guide them and lead them. Make their lives filled with love, happiness, and laughter. Fulfill their dreams and make their birthday or wedding anniversary an amazing one. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Intercessory prayers. Your response shall be, Come, Holy Spirit. Come, Holy Spirit, renew the whole creation. Send the wind and the flame of your transforming life to lift up the church in this day. Give wisdom and faith that we may know the great hope to which we are called. Come, Holy Spirit. Giver of life, sustain our creation, confront us with our greedy consuming of your gifts. Stand before us as we pillage and destroy. Call us forth into new harmonies of care for all that lives and breathes and has its being. Come, Holy Spirit. Spirit of the truth, set us free to emerge as the children of God. Open our ears that we may hear the weeping of the world. Open our mouth that we may be your voice for the voiceless. Open our eyes that we may see your vision of peace and justice. Make us alive with the courage and faith for your prophetic truth. Come, Holy Spirit. Spirit of unity, reconcile your people. Give us the wisdom to hold to what we need to be your church. Give us a vision of your breadth and length and height that will challenge our smallness of heart and bring us humbly together. Come, Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, transform and sanctify us as we take up this task in your name. Give us the gift we need to be your church in spirit and in truth. Come, Holy Spirit. Let us pray for the afflicted in time of pandemic. Let us pray also for all those who suffer the consequences of the current pandemic, that God the Father may grant health to the sick, strength to those who care for them, comfort to families, and salvation to all the victims who have died. Almighty and ever-living God, only support of our human weakness, look with compassion upon the sorrowful condition of your children who suffer because of this COVID second wave. Relieve the pain of the sick. Give strength to those who care for them. Welcome into your peace those who have died. And throughout this time of tribulation, grant that we may all find comfort in your merciful love, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Let us pray for the end of the pandemic. Let us pray, dearly beloved, for a swift end to the coronavirus pandemic that afflicts our world, that our God and Father will heal the sick, strengthen those who care for them, and help us all preserve in faith. Almighty and merciful God, source of all life, health of healing, look with compassion on our world, brought low by disease. Protect us in the midst of the grave challenges that assails us. And in your fatherly providence, grant recovery to the stricken, strengthen to those who care for them, and success to those working to eradicate this surge. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us receive the blessings in faith. Now to him who, by the power at work within us, is able to accomplish abundantly far more than we can ask or imagine, to him we glory, to the church and in Christ Jesus, to all generations forever and ever. Amen.
Dear sisters and brothers in Christ, let us commune with our Lord. Shall we break the bread? How very good and pleasant it is when people of God live together in unity. We who are many are one body, for we all partake of the one bread. Now I will offer in this tent sacrifices with shouts of joy. I will sing and make melody to the Lord. Let us offer to one another the sign of peace through namaskar, and say to one another, the peace of the Lord be with you. The peace of the Lord be with you, and also with you. Now as we sing the offertory hymn, let us offer our thank offering to God. Members can either do online payment to the church bank account or set apart their tithes and offerings and pay to the church office and obtain a receipt. The church QR code and the bank details will be projected on the screen. Shall we sing to the glory of God, Come Holy Ghost, our souls inspire.
Come Holy Ghost, our souls inspire.
Present these offerings with them ourselves for the service of the Divine Majesty. Let us pray. O Father, you have given us a new and living way to offer ourselves to you. Though unworthy, we come to you as we are. By that way, your Son, Jesus of Nazareth, and in his name, we ask you to accept and use us and these gifts, however it best pleases you. All that is created is yours, and everything that we can offer already belongs to you. Amen.
Rejoicing in the presence of our Lord Jesus Christ amidst us, shall we all in unison say the prayer of presence? Be present, O Jesus, you good high priest, as you were in the midst of your disciples, and make yourself known to us in the breaking of the bread, who lives and reigns with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, world without end. Amen. The Lord be with you, and also with you. Lift up your hearts. We lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord, our God. It is right to give God thanks and praise. Truly it is right and good to glorify you at all times and in all places. We're offering you our thanksgiving, O Lord, Holy Father. You spoke and the light shattered darkness, order arose from confusion. You breathed into the dust of the earth and we were formed in your image. Through your Son, our Lord Jesus, you came to us while we wandered. He met us as a refugee, a threatened child. He called us by name to leave what is comfortable, to be his disciples, friends and partners. With his outstretched arms on the cross and through his death, he bore our sins, and through his resurrection, we are saved. And through your Holy Spirit, you brood over chaos that we create, mothering us and shaping a new creation. You enlighten everyone coming into the world. You inspire the prophets and the apostles to find the right word at the right time. You liberate, equip, and commission your people for the continuance of your mission to make everything new. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim and sing your glory. Holy, 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 Lord God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Our Lord Jesus Christ, on the night in which he was betrayed, took bread,
And when he had given thanks to you, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. The same way after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this whenever you drink it, in remembrance of me. Lord, we commemorate your death on the cross, we celebrate your resurrection, and we await your coming. Eternal God, let your Holy Spirit move in power over us, over these earthly gifts of bread and wine, that they may be the communion of the body and blood of Christ, and that we may become one in him. May his coming in glory find us ever watchful in prayer, strong in truth and love, and faithful in the breaking of the bread. Then at last, all peoples will be free, all divisions healed, and with your whole creation, we will sing your praise through your Son, Jesus Christ, through Christ, with Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit. All glory and honor are yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Amen. As our Savior Christ has taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, holy be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For yours is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Let us prepare ourselves to be part of the Lord's table. Shall we all, with true penitent heart, say the prayer of humble access? We do not presume to come to this your table, merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in your manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs on your table, but you are the same Lord whose nature is always to have mercy. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of your dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful bodies and souls may be made clean by his most precious body and blood, that we may evermore dwell in him and he in us. Amen. When we break the bread, do we not share in the body of Christ? We seek to share your life, gracious Lord. When we lift the cup, do we not share in the lifeblood of Christ? We seek to share your life, gracious God. Shall we sing, O Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Having now by faith received the sacrament of the body and blood of Christ, let us give thanks. Let us follow the litany of thanksgiving. Merciful God of all creation, Holy Father of all people, through our Lord Jesus Christ, who united all things in his fullness, we join your whole creation in excellent praise of your bountiful goodness. You have now touched us with new life and filled us with new hope, that the rain will come, that the hungry will be fed, that the oppressed will be set free from evil, that a reconciling work will be done, that love and faithfulness meet together, that justice and peace will kiss each other, and the whole creation filled with your glory. Amen. Blessing and glory and wisdom and thanksgiving, and honor and power and might be unto God forever and ever. Amen. Our closing hymn is, Breathe on Me, Breath of God.
Breathe on me, breath of God, fill me with life anew, that I may love what God does now, and do what thou wouldst do.
Let us receive God's blessings in faith. The peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst you and remain with you always.